Hi, and welcome to the support series videos from Vectra. In this series, engineers will go through some of the common requests we see from customers and how to resolve them. Please be sure to subscribe and check back for new videos in the series.
Hi all, welcome to Vectra support video series. I am Mohammed Pasha from Vectra support team. In this video, we will look at how to change the CLI password of a sensor. Now, as you can see here, so I've got one sensor paired to this brain, and basically the sensor has come with a default password that needs to be changed by the customer. Now, in order to find what the default passwords are, you can go to this KB article, which is KBVS1196, and then you can take a look at the default username and passwords that are available. Now, in this case, I'm running in my lab version which is higher than 5.4, so the default password is change this password. So I'm gonna go ahead and so this is the brain. Sorry. Yeah, and let me grab the IP address of the sensor. Yeah. I'm gonna log in as SSH. So let me copy the default password. Yeah, so now as you can see, so this is the default password that is configured on a sensor that by default. So in order to change the password, CLI password of the sensor, this can be done by the UI of the brain. So all the paired sensors, so let's go back to the brain here. So now in order to change the password, you need to go to data source and network, and within network go to sensors, and as you can see right at the bottom, there's an option called a CLI password sensors. Click on edit, change the password. So now if you can see, the password is set. So this password will be updated or pushed to all the paired sensors. It might take about 5 minutes. So I'm gonna just go ahead and pause the video. So all right, so let's do show sensors again on the brain. Grab this. Do a search right from at this. I'm going to copy the default password. There you go. The default password no longer works. I'm going to go ahead and enter the new password. Yep. So the password works now. So, I mean, so basically, note that this password will be applied to all sensors paired with this brain because we are pushing it from the brain. Now there is also what we can do is, so there's also a parameter where you can do a set password. So as you can see here, set password. The only problem is, I mean, this is not available on sensors if the password is managed by brain, which is what we just did. I mean, this is not possible because the brain is again going to go ahead and update the password of the CLI of the sensor. So yeah, that's it for this video. Hope this has been informative. Have a great day. Thank you.